So, okay, for this lesson, what we're going to need is you're going to need your breadboard. You're going to need your Arduino. You're going to need an LED, a 330-ohm resistor. That would be one of the ones that's orange, orange, brown, gold, or the color code. And then some jumper wires, just some pieces of wire. What we're going to do is we're going to wire up our breadboard and get it set for a lot of things we're going to do. Now, if you read through the webpage, you know that when we look at the breadboard, we have these rows here of five LEDs, and these are connected. So if I plug two wires into the same row, it's as if I took the wires and twisted them together. So if I took this black wire and put it in there, and then I took this red wire and put it into the same row, not the same hole, the same row. So you can see there's even space between them. These two are connected. They're electrically connected. I could even move this over and I could put them in the far ends and they would still be connected. So rows are connected. Columns, however, are not. If I do this, this is not connected. All right? Now, in the central portion, we've got these two sets. We've got a set of five holes. We have a break and then another set of five holes. So if you look at row one here, for example, it's not the same as row one on the other side. They're actually distinct from each other. All right. Now, the numbers here don't mean anything. You can match those up to the numbers on your Arduino board, but they don't really mean anything. They're just for reference. Now, the other thing is the side rails will go down all the way. And you can see they're in groups of five again. But you see how there's that blue line there? That blue line indicates that this is actually connected all the way down the length. So if I wanted these two wires connected on the side rails, I could put this here, and then I could put this anywhere along as long as I put it in the blue side. See? If I put it down here next to it in the on the red side, these two wires are not connected. Now, what we tend to do with these is we hook our power up to these so that we can then have power on our board. Another thing I like to do when I first get a breadboard out, and it's the first time I'm using it, is I'll take a red wire and I'll plug it from positive on one side and I'll take it and I'll plug it into positive on the other side. And then I'll do the same thing for negative. So that when I'm done, I've got positive to positive, negative to negative. And now if I wire power to either side, I've got power all the way down all my rails. And that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to come over here to my breadboard, and I'm going to look, and I'm going to see there where it says positive 5, I'm going to plug in a wire. And then I'm going to plug that. Sorry, drop my wire. So I'm going to take and I'm going to plug in this wire to positive 5 on my Arduino. And then I'm going to take the other end of that, and I'm just going to plug it in. It doesn't matter where I plug it in, as long as it's somewhere in the red row. Now, I've got positive power going to both sides of my breadboard. Now, I'm going to do the same thing for negative. On our Arduino, you'll notice that there are two holes labeled G and D. Either of those will work. So I'm going to plug this in to one of the G and D lines, and then I'm going to plug the other end in to our negative row. And it doesn't really matter where it's plugged in. Now I've got negative power to the whole board. Now I want to hook up my LED. Now, on the site, it talked about the fact that when we look at our LEDs, one leg will be shorter than the other, and the shorter leg is our negative. This is a common convention. Ours, they're pretty darn close. One is slightly shorter, and if you look close, you'll see it. The other convention that is often used, if you roll the LED around and feel the edges, you'll notice right along this lip, there's one side is flattened. And if I roll this, you might see that in the video. It's kind of hard to see, but you can see one edge is flattened. There, I caught a little light. The flat side is also negative. So what you're going to do is when you've got your Arduino plugged in, you'll know it's plugged in when you see the green power light. We are now putting power out of these, to these wires, to these rails. I can then take my LED and make sure I know which side is negative. I'm going to plug the negative into our negative rail, and I'm going to plug the positive side of our LED into row 15. It doesn't really matter what row you plug it in. Then I need my resistor. Resistors are not polarized. It doesn't matter which way those go. I'm going to plug one into row 15. Doesn't matter where in row 15, as long as it's in row 15 on the same side as our central break. And I'm going to plug the other side into positive. And you can see the LED lit up. Pretty cool. Now, it doesn't matter where the LED is relative to the resistor. I could reverse this as long as the negative of my LED is pointed towards the negative rail. So if I wanted to change this, I could do this differently by, say, taking the positive of my LED and plugging it into the positive rail, and then plug the negative into some other row. In this case, it looks like I hit row 8. So in row 8, it's the negative of my LED. I could then take the resistor, same row, and plug it into the negative power, and it lights up. Doesn't matter what order the components are in, as long as I have a complete circuit. I have one path that goes all the way from the positive power to negative power. One path means one circuit. Now, something to be aware of, if you're not being very careful and you inadvertently connect positive directly to negative with no other components in the way, no LEDs or no resistors, then what's going to happen is the light on your Arduino board is going to go out because you've short-circuited your board. Now, if the power light ever goes out on your Arduino, unplug it immediately from the computer, because what's likely happening on the computer at that same instant is it's giving you an error message. So if that happens, you're likely to see an error message on your computer that says one or more of your USB devices tried to draw too much power, and so it was shut off. If that happens, if you get an error message like that, that tells you something about power on your USB port, you'll have to unplug your Arduino. You'll likely have to restart your computer in order to bring back the USB port, but it should be fine. So if that happens, you will have to restart your computer. Now, the other thing that can happen is if you don't include a resistor with your LED, the LED will light up. It'll just burn out very rapidly, and we don't want that to happen. All right? So try that. See if you can light up an LED. Try to light up an LED with the pencil lead, kind of like Colin did in the one resistor video as well. It's kind of cool. So try that out. Make sure that you don't short your LED in that case, because, again, you'll fry it.